and then plus I lambda, this one, and psi here, and I will have to write this commutation relation. So this commutation relation inside, and then psi greater r equal to 0. This commutation relation is inside. Now we will have to work out this commutation relation. So this commutation relation, the a minus a commutation with b minus b is like this multiplied with this. So a minus a and b minus b minus, then b minus b and a minus a here. So 2 multiply and we will get a b. So this will be a b minus b times a, and then minus a times b, and minus minus plus a b, and then we will have minus sign, and this will be b a. So minus b a and minus a b. So minus minus become plus, so plus a b, and then b minus b a. So minus minus plus plus b a, and then minus minus b a b. So it will become plus and then minus, so minus a b. Is this is just a number, so their order doesn't matter. Now if I look here, then b a is cancelling with this and a b with this. These two are cancelling, and for this commutation relation I got that this is equal to the commutation of actually a b minus b a. So this is the a b commutation relation. So I will have to replace in my expression that this commutation is actually a b commutation relation. So from here I can write my relation is that psi a minus a whole square psi plus lambda square and psi b minus b whole square psi plus I lambda plus I lambda and the commutation relation of a and b. So psi and commutation of a with b psi. And this is greater or equal to 0. Now as I considered here that a minus a squared, this is the expectation value of sigma a square. So for this one I can write sigma a squared plus lambda squared sigma b squared and plus I lambda, and this will be the AB relation, the commutation relation of AB, and this is greater or equal to zero. Means I wrote this thing without the psi here, and now I will have to solve this one. Now I know that I will have to solve this thing for the value of lambda, that what is lambda equal to, then I will come to know, because this is an unknown constant, we will have to determine the value of this one, and when it is equal to zero, this will be the minimum value of this, and this will be greater than zero for a maximum value. And we know the extreme value condition, that if we are having a function f of x, and if I want to find the maximum values of this, so for the extreme values, the maximum or minimum values, I will have to minimize this one. So it is that if I take its derivative with respect to the variable x, and this I make equal to zero, then this will give me the extreme values of the function. So I do for this one that I do derivate this one with respect to lambda, because the variable here is our lambda, and then sigma a square plus lambda square sigma b squared plus I lambda and A B, and this is equal to zero. So this implies that this one is zero plus 2 lambda sigma B squared plus I times A B commutation, and this is equal to zero, and I can write that lambda from here is equal, when this will come here it will become minus A B, and this 2 lambda will also come here, so 2 will come here and lambda is here. So the value of lambda implies that if I move this one to the denominator, it will come plus I. So this is 1 over 2i and a b. So I have determined the value of lambda. Now I will have to put the value of lambda. Okay, I forgot one thing, sigma b squared here, so this is a b over sigma b squared. So I will have now to put the value of lambda big in this equation, so I will get that sigma a squared plus, what about lambda square? So lambda square will become 1, this is a b divided by 2i sigma b squared, and this is whole squared sigma b squared plus I, and lambda I will put the value, so 1 over 2i and a b divided by sigma b squared. Sigma b squared here, and then AB will automatically, this one come here, and this is AB, and the whole expression is greater or equal to zero. So what we got here, that this I is cancelling with this I, this will become sigma B 4. So when it is 4, then it will cancel, it will cancel with this 2 and it will become 2 here. Similarly, these two will multiply and they will become squared. So I will have the relation sigma A squared plus, this will be A B squared divided by, now this will become 4i squared, so it will become minus 4 here, and sigma B will only remain a squared, plus this will become AB whole squared divided by 2 and sigma B squared greater or equal to 0, and this thing is then implied. If I multiply this whole expression with sigma B square, then I will get sigma A squared sigma B squared, and this sigma B square will cancel, and I will have minus 1 over 4 and A B commutation plus 1 over 2 and AB commutation, and both are squared and greater or equal to 0. So what about minus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 2? We will get again plus 1 over 4. So sigma A squared sigma B squared and minus, so it will become plus, and 1 over 4 A B whole squared greater or equal to 0, and this implies that sigma A squared sigma B squared is equal to sigma A squared sigma B squared is equal, greater or equal, when this will come on this side, it will become minus 1 over 4 AB whole squared, and minus 1 over 4 I can write is 1 over 2i, so 1 over 2i, and AB, and this is whole squared. So sigma A sigma B greater or equal to this whole squared, and now the square cancellation can take place, and I will have, this implies that sigma A sigma B is greater or equal to A B commutation over 2i. And now if I take the commutation of x and p, for A B I take this commutation, this canonical commutation I have already found, that this is equal to I h bar. So put the value I h bar here, then sigma A sigma B is greater or equal. When I h bar is here, I are cancelling, and this is h bar over 2, and we have derived the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. And now with the help of Ehrenfest theorem, one can prove the other uncertainty principle for the energy as well. So this is sigma. So this is the Heisenberg uncertainty principle for the position and momentum, while for the energy and time, one can prove the Heisenberg uncertainty principle by considering some calculation from here and from the Ehrenfest theorem. One can prove the other counterpart, and hence this is the proof of the Heisenberg uncertainty principle.